but
hey, I'm sitting here with G and Juan. We're back. This is part three.
Y'all tired of us yet?
We were last discussing the hoop. There was a lot of, on social media, people were very angry when Michael Sams showed up with his white partner. They were kissing on TV because he was accepted with the Yuskewood football team.
St. Louis Rams. Which he's been officially signed now, so congratulations to Michael Sams.
Congratulations, Michael. I think he's way handsome there.
Yeah.
Interracial relationship, what do you think about that? Why do you think?
Well, I'm a product of interracial relationship. So, I mean, obviously not, I don't have a problem with interracial relationships.
Sure,
I think love is love. My father is black and my mom is white.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's not a big deal to me.
Okay.
You know?
The issue here is everybody is concerned with everyone else's business but their own.
Of course.
Mind your own business and you won't even be affected with interracial relationships. Let that man date, kiss, whoever he wants. Everybody was like, he was in a sea of white. Where was the black people? That's his life. Everybody is not pro-black. Everyone's not surrounded by black people. We have a different struggle. We have our different roads to wherever we get. Let him live his life.
Well, don't you find it strange that so many of our out African Americans that are coming out, what's the basketball player? I can't think of his
name. Jason Collins.
So I don't know what his partner looks like. I would love to know, Jason. But it's so many of these guys are choosing white over black. Why do you think they're doing this?
I don't think that they're choosing one over the other.
Okay.
Like, I don't think that they set out to intentionally, I don't want to be attracted to, I'm attracted to black guys, I'm attracted to this guy, but I'm not going to talk to him because he's black because I want, white is better. I don't think that that's their mindset. I simply believe that that's what they're attracted to.
And just love.
And that is just love. Now, I will say this. I do wonder, you know, with a lot of the guys that are coming out that are, you know, high-profile celebrities,
mm-hmm.
I will say that I think that maybe influence is the right word. The influence of him dealing with a white partner,
mm-hmm.
As opposed to dealing with a black partner, I think that it's, how can I carefully say this, but I think that it's probably a little bit more comfortable for him to come out. Because there's not as much, and just like in the black community, a lot of us, and it lends hand to the interracial relationship, but a lot of the black community, we don't come out as much as other races.
Okay.
So when you're dealing with someone who isn't black, and you have a layer of oppression that's not there anymore. You're dealing with this white guy, he's probably already out, and then when his family's like, oh, you know, come on, blah, blah, so I think it helps you, it might can help that black person, like Michael Sam or Jason Collins, feel a little bit more comfortable coming out, because maybe they might have some more support, I don't know, but I think that the fact that the whole discreetness of being a black gay man plays a part in
not choosing
the white partner, but those are the ones that we're seeing that's coming out.
Okay.
Now, let's say Michael Sam was with a black man.
Okay.
Let's say he was with a black man. I think that there would be another layer of challenges because I don't feel like, I do feel like maybe that white counterpart can be, they just, a little bit more supportive of him coming out.
Because they're more comfortable.
I feel like it needs to be examined on a psychological level.
Mm.
Like, if you look at someone who is open to interracial dating, whether they be straight or gay, your thought processes, your mindset, your outlook on life is different than someone who's like, I'm only dating within my race.
Right.
You know, you're not held by these rigid standards. Now you add the gay layer onto it. So I'm already attracted to white dudes, Asian dudes, Hispanic dudes. I'm open from that perspective.
All right.
So psychologically, I'm more open to facing this challenge of coming out now. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So all these celebrities who date white men, they're already psychologically in tune with being more open-minded.
Well, do you think that there are black gay athletes who are in black gay relationships in their high hiding their sexuality because the partner doesn't want to come
out. I've been in a relationship where I didn't come out because my partner wasn't ready. And that's what I'm saying. So when you're dealing with two black men and the struggle to come out as a black gay man is already there, and now you only have one person in a relationship who's fighting that struggle, then you have a partner who's pulling you up instead of saying, no, we're not ready yet, you can't do that, you know, the church is going to do this, or everybody's not going to accept a black gay man. But when you don't have that other half that's actually living life free, and his family is accepting, and all, and that's your environment, that's what you're around, so maybe that helps build your security.
Is there any reason at all for African-American gay men to hide his sexuality?
Yeah, I think that there's reasons. Everybody has their reasons.
Valid reasons.
I think if it's their reasons, I think it's valid to them. I mean, I might not be able to say it's valid, but I think it's easy for me to say as an out black gay man, like, no, everybody should come out. This life is great. Mm-hmm. But, you know, my experience is also not the same as theirs. So I do feel like... I feel like everybody should be able to be themselves, but I also understand that the road to that point is not the same for everybody. So everybody might not be as strong, quote unquote, as the next person, and their journey is just a bit different.
Okay.
But
I mean, I think, and may get some flack for this, I do feel like when it comes to your safety, if like say you live in Jamaica.
Okay.
You know, I can see why someone would be in the closet. Exactly. So if your safety is called into question, then I can understand that. I can understand everybody's experience.
Being African American in America, United States of America,
Atlanta, Georgia,
didn't have a valid reason to hide.
Valid, yes. I guess I'm valid. I don't understand what you're saying by valid. Like, I'm not. I think you say that they. But this is why I say this. I feel like to say somebody does not have a valid reason for whatever they're doing is just placing judgment.
And say,
I don't want to say that.
On our terms.
Yes.
And that's not fair. So you're saying that it's okay to hide your sexuality, though?
I do think on some level it's okay for you to hide what you want to hide. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you want to hide whatever about yourself, yes, that's okay if you want to do that. Now, is the healthiest thing for you to do? No. But, you know, you have your own walk, and if that's okay for you, then that's okay for you. And who am I to say that it's not okay?
Yeah, I agree with that. I think it becomes to get into that, like, if you're involving other people. Like, once other people come into play, you're hiding, and your hiding stuff affects them.
Yeah.
That's when it's no longer all right. It's not valid anymore.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, because now you're bringing somebody else into it.
Don't you feel that guys would be more healthier?
Yes, definitely. I'm a big champion of coming out of the closet.
But just how many years ago? 10 years ago, I was the one in the closet of shame and living a double life. And you know, it's easy to forget that once you're living and you're out and you're proud and you're just like you said, why won't everybody come out? But we all have that struggle, and we can't force anyone. Because anyone could force me out.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So we can't force other people to live like us.
Mm-hmm. If you're in a relationship, you're in a black gay relationship, a lot of people like to do threesomes, foursomes, group sex, whatever, menage a trois. I don't know what to call it. Should be that. What do you guys think about that type of stuff?
I think that as long as, I think that, like, we go back to say that a relationship is what you agree upon, I feel like those things are fine if that's what you want to do, and if you and your partner have open communication, that's what y'all talking about. I think it becomes a problem when you're doing all those things and your partner is unaware and you're deceiving them.
Gotcha.
But if that's what you want to do, be honest about that, have that open communication with whoever you're with, and however y'all meet in the middle, if your partner feels the same way, then y'all both do it together, and it's great. If it's a problem, maybe that won't work for him, but give your partner a chance to accept what you want to do.
Gotcha.
So it can work if everybody agrees upon that was happening, but it obviously can tear relationships apart when you start deceiving people, or you get into a relationship and you think you love a person so much that you have to accept some stuff, like menage a trois or threesomes, that you're not really comfortable with. But just to hold on to the relationship, you're going to sell that part of your soul.
I have talked to people who have been pressured into doing these types of things to keep their relationship. They love this person so much, And this person presented something to them, and they went along with it because they wanted this relationship to work. And so they did things sexually with other people that they may not necessarily have wanted to do, but they did do it
for the sake of the relationship.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, and they compromised themselves. And I always say this, like, I want to do X, whatever X may be. He's not that into it. If he is like, no, I want to do this. If I love him enough, I can say, you know what? I don't want you to do it because you really don't want to do it. And I need to adjust. Mm-hmm. But to force someone into some sexual situation or a sex party, blah, 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 then you don't really love them, in my opinion.
I agree.
Because you're making them do something. And it's not like a compromise just within, like, that's sex. Mm-hmm. And some people hold sex very sacredly. And for him to compromise himself to please you and you not recognize that and still make him do it, I would analyze, you know, our foundation in our relationship.
Is this something that you guys would do together? Sex, not to trust, recently?
No, it's, you know what? I think, like you said, we don't really discuss our sex life. But what I will say is I feel like sex parties and all of this stuff, that's entertainment. And people indulge in various types of entertainment. I feel like but that's like for young people. You know, and maybe because in my past, and I don't hide this, like I've been to sex parties, I've done whatever, but that's like when you're young and dumb and full of cum and you don't know no better. That's how I feel about it. And that's how, and so, and I
think, I'm gonna get your opinion on that.
So it's like, like I said, actions that are conducive to a relationship, if you're growing, to me, my opinion,
okay,
and if I'm in relationship mode, growing, blah, 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 I'm not out doing those things anymore.
All right, Gene, you were against the sex party.
No, I disagree with the statement that he said that, you know, sex parties or threesomes or those type of sex situations are for younger people. That's the part I disagree with. Like, I don't think that's just for young people. I don't think once you get 30 or 35 that your sexual desires necessarily change or you should do something different sexually. I think sex is a freedom of expression, and I feel like you should be free sexually, you know, whatever age that is. And if anything, the older you get, the more responsible you are able to handle those slight situations. So it might be smarter to wait until you're older, because when you're young, dumb, and full of cum, you tend to make...
Well, let me tell you something. I'm 44 years of age. I ain't been to a sex party yet, and I don't think they want to...
You know Walter is wholesome.
Well, I think they would ban me at the door. Oh, yeah, that motherfucker ain't coming in here.
And I made that statement as it related to sex parties and orgies as form of entertainment. I feel like...
I didn't really do it as entertainment, but I'm glad you said that.
Because I did.
Okay.
I do feel like certain couples...
I feel like the sex is entertainment.
Yeah. You know, from porn to being a exhibitionism, all of that stuff is a form of entertainment to me. But what I was saying is I do believe couples can do what they want to do sexually, and inviting another person into their bedroom, to me, is not the same as a sex party. You know, that's just you enhancing your sexual life or whatever you may call it. But the culture... surrounding sex parties and orgies and all that, there's a culture around that. Oh, and I feel like, to me, indulging in that culture is a younger state of mind.
Okay. Do you think that when people invite someone into their bedroom that it could cause conflict within the relationship? Could it tear the relationship apart? Is it something that, if you're going to do something like that, you really have to prepare yourself for the consequences of what could happen?
I feel like any time you bring someone in, whether it be sexually, emotionally, or you are too open with your friends, or you're bringing them into your issues in your relationship, you open it up to being torn apart. A threesome specifically, yeah, but if you haven't talked, you know, communication, if you don't have boundaries, and I studied this in college too, you need the boundaries, you need the rules. Without that, it's just chaos, and there's room for anything.
Okay. Change the subject for a second. You guys have joint checking accounts. You share credit accounts together. Mm-hmm. So you have joint checking accounts. Your last home you own together. Mm-hmm. So you believe that as a gay couple you should buy homes together, buy real estate together, buy cars together? Is that...
Well, I feel like if you commit yourself to build a life together, then anything that you guys...
Open a business together.
Well, that's something you want to do, yeah. I mean, but I think that it should all be transparent. And if you're truly building together, then it's not, this is yours and this is mine. It's this is ours, and that includes our bills, and that includes our cars, and that includes our houses.
Does it make your relationship stronger?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I definitely think it bonds you.
Living together. How long have you guys been living together?
We moved together probably about 4 months after we
met. 4 months.
And that was like that's when the official movement happened.
Right. I was over this place.
But it was 4 months. You all lived together. In 4 months, you guys were just staying together. You still had separate places.
We had separate places up until 4 months.
At the end of four, that's pretty quick.
It's very quick.
And you can recommend this for other people.
I recommend you being as honest with your feelings as you possibly can.
Okay.
And I say that to say, you know, I feel like time is a man-made thing. Yes, the sun sets and all that, but the way we look at time. We have to date someone for 6 months before we could do this or do that. Mm-hmm. But says who? If it feels right, go do it.
Oh, I have to say this, because I'm sitting here, I know Juan Gee, I've been around him a lot. The love is here. I feel it. It's just this room, the house, the warmth. I feel it.
Oh,
you know, because I wasn't sure what it was going to be like doing this. So I was like, but as I'm sitting here, I'm like, these guys really love each other. There's something here. The fact that you're doing a video, you're so open, you're so out, you're exposing yourselves. Does it help you? Does it help the relationship?
I think it helps us to remain honest within our relationship.
Mm-hmm.
It definitely does. And I think anytime you speak the truth and you open yourself up and to be in such a vulnerable space, even with you and here,
uh-huh.
I definitely think that it bonds you and keeps you close.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I think the love works. I love the campaign as I see it. To bring that.
And I'm
love.
Glad you see it that way, because it's really is what it is.
Yeah. Well, I think it's a campaign for love.
Yeah.
Because so many people in our community don't see it.
Yeah.
They don't understand what love is. I remember when I first got on Facebook, someone asked the question, why does somebody stay in a relationship for 5 or 6 years with one person? And I remember my response was, the reason why you stay together so long is because you love each other. And the person removed my comment.
Really?
On Facebook. They deleted it. So I remember inboxing the person saying, did you take my comment down? You know, and they were like, I didn't think it was felt that this was a very well-known person in our community, he felt my comment was not very sincere. And I'm thinking, who would stay in a relationship with somebody that you don't love?
Mm-hmm.
Who would be, I've been with a girl for 18 years, but I didn't love this man, I've been and shoved his ass off a cliff.
Right, yeah, it would.
I mean, at the end, that's where love works comes from, because at the end of the day, love works in any situation. You know, and it can heal any wound, and it can solve any problem at the end of the day.
And love is what is the glue that's binding you guys together.
Yeah, it really is. Yeah.
And it's not even just romantic relationships. Friendships, too.
Oh, right.
Like, a lot of stuff we write about, it's like, it can apply to your mama and your daddy, you know, how you just interact with people in general.
Okay.
And I know it keeps me honest, because it keeps me like, shit, you need to take your own advice.
And it's not always easy. You know, because we go through our own challenges in the relationships, and sometimes it's not always easy to be active and writing on Love Works when I feel like we're going through challenges on our own. Mm-hmm. So we go through those periods as well, and that gives us more writing material, because now we've learned some stuff and we can kind of open ourselves up to that kind of stuff. So we you know, really try, and I hope it comes across, to make people realize, because a lot of people look from the outside looking in like we have this perfect relationship, and it's perfect for us, but it comes along with this share of challenges.
Yeah, it's something that you consistently work at.
Yeah, you do.
Yes.
You do.
Okay. Well, I've enjoyed this last hour discussing that, maybe a little over an hour. I hope that you guys invite me back to do some more videos.
Absolutely.
Definitely. I really enjoyed this. I appreciate you guys reaching out to me to give me an opportunity to do this. I really do. Like I said, sitting here in their home, I know it's the love. I think it's a great thing. I think relationships are the most important thing in life.
Yeah, it is.
For people to go through life, because I've got so many friends who've never been in a relationship. What would you say to these individuals 20, 30 years 40 years of age.
I would really want to ask them to ask themselves why. Like, there's definitely, relationships are, we're meant to connect with other human beings, you know. So relationships are really there to help us grow. And so I would ask a person who's never been in a relationship for, you know, 20, 30 years that, why? Why haven't you, because obviously the only answer for me is they haven't opened themselves up to a relationship. So it's like, why?
Fear, bitterness?
I think it's a lot of that. Fear, bitterness, depression, insecurities.
But you probably get past that if you acknowledge that,
that's why. And acknowledge, it's not just because I haven't found the guy who's magical enough for me, or that's not the case. If you've met over 20 years, you've met all these people and it's all of them.
Do you think people have unrealistic expectations?
Yes.
The list of stuff that this person wants to meet.
Everybody thinks that it's a fairy tale.
Juan, exactly what your list of expectations?
He was my 80, definitely my 80%.
He was 80%.
You know, he was definitely 80%. But you know what? And it wasn't, and for me, when I met him, I said I was never going to date anybody under a certain age, and he was under that age.
Okay.
You know, I wasn't going to date a person that didn't have a car. At the time, he was going through some challenges with his license, all that stuff. He didn't have a car.
Okay.
You know, all those different things. But I think what I felt about him, that was my one and only standard.
Okay.
That is my standard. This is how I need to feel. Everything else can be worked out there.
Okay.
You know, you can't fake the chemistry or the love or the feelings. You can get past you can get past credit problems, and you can get past having a baby mama. You know, that's my bag. You can get past that stuff, but you can't fake the feeling. And a lot of times, I think maybe some people run away from that feeling. Nobody wants to get burned, or nobody wants to play the fool. Silly and me. What's the song we were singing last time? You know, and nobody wants to play the fool, and they always want to guard their heart and guard their feelings. And I think that a lot of times that prevents them from
having a
healthy, long-lasting relationship.
I always tell people this, and it's so simple that it's so hard. Look at what you're doing in your romantic life, and then do the opposite. Because whatever you're doing hasn't worked up until now. Before you ain't got no man.
Yeah, that's true.
Do the exact opposite of everything you've been doing.
So you think, are some people just meant to be single?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so. Not at the core.
What about you, G?
Meant to be single. I can't say if somebody's... Some people maybe are. They are meant to be single. But I think that nobody is meant not to experience love. I will say that. Nobody is meant not to experience love. Whether that be single or in a relationship or whatever have you, that's that. But love is at the core of our being, and everybody's meant to experience.
What's the website again?
The website is www.juanandgee.com for everything Juan and G.
And that's G-E-E.
G-E-E.com.
And your Facebook page is?
Facebook is Love Works with Juan and G. We have Instagram, Juan and G. Twitter, Juan and G.
TheGentlemen'sFoundation.org.
In G Productions, we plan events so we can plan your big ass gay wedding.
Right.
You know, make it fabulous event.
But WanaG.com has links there.
Yeah, it has links to everything. So you can just go there and add.
WanaG.com, Love Works. Guys, thank you for inviting
me. Thank you
so much. Yeah, appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
You've been trying to do this for a couple of months now.
Every time we pass each other in the gym and he walk around, he's like, but yeah, so I'm glad we was able to do it.
I'm glad we finally got it done. Thanks, guys. I'm out of here. Enjoy your weekend. And we're going to do real. I'm going to come back and see you guys again.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. You're always welcome.
All right. Bye.
Cut.